Because in this world, when we say imaginary, something is imaginary. But in that world, everything manifests really a form. It's not something material, it's something. It's like a gross form, actually. That Yogamaya manifests. Yogamaya manifests a gross form of everything. Whether it's like manifested or it's only the bhav in the heart, but still. Like suppose, there's no snake there actually. But just to make the pastimes, Yogamaya arranges that. Yogamaya manifests in the form of a snake also. Like Srimati Radhika was angry many times at all. Srimati Radhika was in man and she left Krishna. Krishna tried many things to try to pacify her man. But Srimati Radhika was in man and that's it. So to make them meet again, Yogamaya manifests in the form of a snake. Came in front of Srimati Radhika and started to hiss. Then Srimati Radhika was afraid seeing the snake. Who will protect me? Krishna, Krishna, Mahabhav. Hey Krishna, you're so powerful, please protect me. You see? The man of Srimati Radhika finished and then Radha and Krishna met. So the form of the snake, who was the snake? Yogamaya herself manifesting the form of a snake, or Krishna himself also, you can say it was Krishna himself. Whatever we see in the spiritual world, everything is spiritual, chinmay.
Nittam parasapurusa shikhanda mooli jasya kadar sanidhi visavan ujaya tatkili kunji bhavanangana sat marjanisha.
Our Prabhupada Saraswati says, in the spiritual world, everything is favorable for Krishna's pastimes, nothing is unfavorable. Like a snake is all something unfavorable. But in the spiritual world, even the snakes are favorable for the eating of Radha and Krishna. Actually, in that world, the snake doesn't even bite. It's only like hissing and moving, but actually not biting. One snake was living in the mountain. Whoever would come near that cave, the snake was biting, and people would die, bit by the snake. Then one day, everybody told Narada Rishi, and Narada Rishi came to that village. And all the villagers told Narada Rishi, please tell some tantra mantra that will stop the snake, like the snake will go away from here. Narada Rishi said, okay. He left, he went to that place, and the snake came really to bite Narada Rishi. But then Narada Rishi, with his influence of his bhajan, he was able to stun, make the snake stunned, like not moving. The snake thought, I have already beat so many persons all this time, I bet. No. So, what is this sadhu? He's taking my strength, I cannot bite him. Then, the snake surrendered to Narada Rishi. The snake surrendered to Narada Rishi and told, hey Gurudev, I surrender to you. Whatever you tell me, I will do. Okay? So Narada Rishi told the snake, look, do one thing, stay here, okay? Stay here. Don't, you know, do any violence to anyone. I know, you're a Kaljati. The snakes are violent living entities. Call me somebody who is performing violence and bad things to others. So you have to give up this nature, this violence and all this, and do the bhajan of God. You know, worship God. Narada told the snake. Snake said, okay, I'll stay here. Then snake was staying in that place, just like a dead boy. Then even some young boys started to lift the snake, taking its body, taking the body of snake. And the snake was not doing anything because Narada told the snake, don't do anything from now on. Like, don't bite anyone. So snake was following the instructions. But then the kids of that village saw, oh, that snake was so violent, but now the snake's not doing anything. It was just like, looked like just turning one side to another side like this. But the nature of the boys was like, you know, how the snake used to bite, but now the snake not biting, not doing anything. So they were like kind of playing with the snake, like holding the snake by the tail and moving around the snake in the air. But because of this movement, round movement, the bones of the snake, they broke, you know, the bones. The snake has the bones, you know, this, how to say, backbone, very sensitive bones. So the boys took the tail of the snake and moving. Then all the body of the snake was like broken, you know. And the snake started to vomit blood. The snake was about to die. And the snake remembered its Gurudeva, Narada Rishi, and said, Gurudeva, I gave up the violence. And you see now these boys are almost killing. The small kids even, they took my by the tail, and they have broken all the bones of my body. I'm about to die, Gurudeva, please protect me. Then Narada Rishi told, look, what did I tell you? I showed you should not bite anyone and should not be violent, but I did not forbid you to hiss. If the snakes hiss, like pretend you attack, then the boys will run away. But no, you're just like laying, not doing anything. Then these kids took you and they're playing with you, and in this way they broke all your bones. So in this context, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada explains. For example, if you do some vrat, some vow, which vow you do? Ekadashi and Janmashtami. You don't know any vow for any demigods or demigoddesses, but before you used to do, huh? Now you give up everything. Karavachak. Women, sometimes in India, they follow one vow for the husband. She said, I only follow in front of my mother-in-law, just when she's not. Okay, anyway, Narada Rishi said, I did not prohibit you to hiss, but to bite I prohibited you. To hiss, it's okay. If you'd hiss to the boys, then the boys wouldn't come to you and would not disturb you. So what I want to say is that in the spiritual world, there are snakes there. But those snakes, they are favorable for Krishna's pastimes.
How?
They make the meeting of Radha and Krishna happen. Like I told Srimati Radha collecting man. Krishna tried so many things to try to break her man. But Srimati Radha, she was stubborn, didn't want to break, to be, stop being angry. So how Radha Krishna would meet? The Jogamaya manifested in the form of the snake in the path of Srimati Radha. It was not original Krishna, but Jogamaya herself arranged. Jogamaya manifested in the form of a snake and came in front of Srimati Radha. Srimati Radha was afraid. She started calling out for Krishna. Oh Krishna Mahabhava, please protect me. So the man of Srimati Radha was destroyed. So what I mean is that snakes, scorpions, who becomes these animals? That Krishna himself in one form to relish pastime.
This thing you said, each smaran, like Mother Jashoda, give birth, then the balak grows. Every day one smaran. Each smaran has one form, it's a bigraha. This is what you said. Just can this again and repeat, this is very high and
did you understand what I said? So tell me in Hindi, what do you understand about what I said? Okay, hold this.
I'm asking when he said that in the spiritual world, these naimitic pastimes, they're only Bhava Matra. And he was explaining about Bhava Matra. He said, like, in this world, everything doesn't have a Swarupa. But in that world, everything has a swarupa. Every smaran, every remembrance has a swarupa, vigraha. Like when the boy is growing, every moment, every smaran has a swarupa. He said this, vigraha. So what is this? More. No. Can he explain again this point? Then he's asking her if she understood. She can explain. Can you hold this one?
So lilas are nitya. These lilas have swarupa. They don't have swarupa. Jogamaya only makes the bhava for these lilas.
The bhava.
Bhava is also spiritual, that bhava. Okay, so there's no snake there. So in this spiritual, there's no snake. The snake is only this bhava coming. Or sometimes also Jagamaya herself also manifests as the snake just to make the meeting of Radha and Krishna. Like for example, in this world the snake bites. In that world the snake won't bite. So the Nitya Lilas, they have a swarupa, Naimitika Lilas don't have a swarupa. Yes. For example, the Janam Lila, Krishna has been born. If this Lila was eternal, so every day Mother Yashoda would give birth to a baby, then the swarupa, prakash, manifestation of the form, Mother Yashoda would think, I gave birth to the boy. So all the physical changes that happen when the mom gives birth to a baby, this will also be there. For example, pain, some pain in the body because of the delivery, and so this will make the face become because the face is like a mirror of what we're feeling, a reflection of this.
So, this
divine Divya form, divine form, Jagamaya makes this divine form.
Which aprakta Divya Swarup, Jagamaya Banate? Did you understand? No, did you understand? Jagamaya Banate? Jagamaya makes this aprakta Divya Swarup of what?
Nitya Lila. So the Naimitic Lilas, they are temporary pastimes. They don't have this gross form. It's only Bhava Matra. Only the Bhava. Okay, this I understood. But what is this Bhava Matra? What is this Bhava? If you say about some Bhava, that Bhava is not imaginary. These moods are not imaginary in the spiritual world. They are eternal also. So if they are eternal, they also have a vigraha, a form.
Oh.
To understand this and to explain, this is very hard. Jiva Goswami himself told. Because whatever we speak about in this world, if you give some example, we are giving example, material examples we are giving, right? How can we speak something spiritual speaking about some material example? When you go to that spiritual world, then you see and understand, that's it. There are many things in this world also that you cannot understand by examples. Like for example, how is the sweet? How is a rasagulla? You tell me, how is this taste of a rasagulla? Sweet, okay, but what is sweet taste? What is the sweet taste? If someone has never even eaten sweets, how to explain? I've never eaten rasagulla, suppose. And if you say those rasagulla is really nice today. Okay, so how was the rasagulla? Was sweet. How was that sweet? How can we tell how sweet it was? You can say? By some expressions, you can express. Like if you ask a dumb person doesn't speak. If I ask him, how was the rasagulla? He'll do, he cannot say sweet. He just will do this. We can say sweet. So how is the sweet? You can ask the sweet taste. But a dumb person doesn't speak. So if you ask, how was the sweet? He'll do what? Express her mood with some expression. So the spiritual world, everything of that world is spiritual. Because there is spiritual. Even if we speak about things in this world, we cannot understand those things with these examples. Because when you go there, then you feel anubhav, realization, you feel directly. Experience is something that you can experience only. In Sanskrit it's called swasambiddha-dasa. Swa means your own, samveda means directly feeling. You cannot be explained. It's unexplainable. For example, that thing is sweet. How sweet? It was sweet, that's it. Okay, the word sweet. To express this, how can you explain something which is sweet? You have to give examples and comparisons, isn't it? You know, comparisons. You must use some comparison. Okay, how to explain? How is the sweet taste? We can compare with something of this world, for example. Ah, it's like that thing, like this thing. But actually, it's not true. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada gave an example. You laugh because it's funny. There was one person. It was not summertime. It was not the time of the seasonal mango. It was not the season of the mango. So he took one, he bought in the market one chosha means. So he felt happiness to eat this. He went to the house and told, oh, I went to this place and somebody gave me some very sweet mango, very nice. That person told the mango is so sweet, but how sweet it was. But that person hadn't eaten. The person who ate knows, and he said it was really sweet. But how sweet it was, how sweet. You can eat and you can feel how sweet it was. Because the adjective, when you use adjectives, but actually, even if the language you cannot explain, only the person can feel himself. So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada gave this example. The person had the beard. That person who went to the market and bought one mango and ate. But how was that mango? The happiness you feel
was
But that was not mango. Okay. So he ate that thing, but actually the mango was completely stuck in that. His beard. Chosha is one kind of mango that you have to eat, like sucking the seeds. But he was sucking so much that his beard was full of this mango. So his beard was full of... Because if you don't go to the spiritual world, even if you speak so much about it, always there's some spot of Maya, some like fault of Maya. Do you understand? To explain in language, you need to see that thing directly. For example, Govinda is beautiful. How beautiful he is. You have to express how he is beautiful. But you don't have realization. When Krishna himself appears in your heart, then you can directly see and understand. So when I told Bhava Matra is only a mood in the spiritual world, this is the mythic lila. Just try to understand, it's not gross, it's not a gross form. You understand gross form? Like my elements, five element body. Actually, everything there is transcendental. What is this? Have you ever seen something transcendental? If something I haven't ever seen, it's really hard to explain or to understand. So many people, they are painters and they very quickly paint you. They make like a drawing of your body. So you're sitting here and very quickly, he just look at you very quickly, then he'll make, he'll draw you exactly as you are, like your hair and face and eyes, everything. You'll see everything in you, all your features, your eyebrows and everything, he'll draw accordingly. Why I'm saying this? Because he saw you, he just saw you, then he's drawing. He'll just like make a photograph, like a drawing of you. But that person who has never ever seen, if you tell me, make this drawing, how will you make? Did you understand?
तो कहने की तात्पर्य है उसी प्रकार में ये समझते हैं नवीन तेला जानी कृष्ण के जन्म लीला.
So the birth of Krishna, or for example, how Krishna was born from the mother Yashoda's womb, how also, for example, Nanda Maharaj. All these vigrahas manifest Jagamaya creates. But the other ones like killing demons, then this no. In this world there is the killing of the demons, yes. Do you understand? So the lilas in the spiritual world is called Bhava Matra. Did you understand? In this transcendental world, the Prakriti Goloka Vrindavan, there are two kinds of Krishna's pastimes. Nitya Lila and another Naimittika Lila. This Naimittik Lila also occurs Nitya Lila, eternally. This is it. Anyway, for example, stealing the flute. This Lila, like for example, stealing the flute and in the Jamuna, etc. This is Nitya Lila, eternal pastime. Some Lilas are Nitya Lila, some Lilas are Naimittik Lila. And when you say Naimittik Lila, it's Bhav Matra. They don't have gross form. This is it. Another question? Yeah. The moon attains Stribhava. Because the moon is serving. When the moon arises, when the moon rises, the service of the moon is the best service, the service of the moon. Moon. Because Rasalila happened in the night time, she's asking. Rasalila also can happen during the day. Rasalila includes many lilas, like Madhupan, drinking the honey, Vamshi Chori, stealing flute, all this is included in the Rasalila. Of all the kinds of Sambhogamai lila, mainly all of them also part of Rasalila. Srila Rupa Goswami Pada in the Ujjwala Lamani, he presented 18 lilas. How many? 18 pastimes he has presented in Ujjwala Lamani. Actually, these 18 lilas are the Nitya lilas. And all they are Sringarmai lila. Paramar Modi pastimes are the eternal pastimes. So these are going on eternally. And who is fortunate, they can see these pastimes. This lila is going on eternally, from since time immemorial. So the demigods who fainted. So somebody said, some people say that the demigods says saw a little bit of the feet of Srimati Radhika, then they fainted. Some commentaries explain not that even this was possible. Because if you don't have the body of a gopi, it's not possible for you. So it's necessary to be born in the house of a gopi. So the women of Swarga, they saw a little bit the feet of Srimati Radhika and then they fainted. When you see Krishna, what happens in the heart? You can see the lecture of Gurudeva. Some people say, oh, I have the darshan of Bhagavan. It's useless talk. Some people say, oh, Krishna gave darshan to me. Without bhajan, you cannot see Krishna. It's not possible. Doing bhajan slowly by the mercy of Bhagavan, then Jagamaya will arrange and you have the darshan. If you didn't do bhajan, Bhagavan doesn't give darshan like this so easily. Some people say, ah, every time I close my eyes, Krishna gives me darshan. Some people say.
Every time I close my
eyes. This is cheating propensity. When you have Govinda Darshan, only when Prem appears in your heart, then you see Govinda Darshan. So that Kata said that Dundukari Kata. No, not Dundukari. Ajamil Kata. Ajamil, actually, he asked the Jamadutas. He told, why didn't you take me at that time? You sent the Jamadutas away and. I mean, sorry, then you disappeared after. You brought me back like this. But at that time, why didn't you take me to Vaikuntha at that time? Then, Vishnu Dutas told, at that time, we were only chanting Namabhas, the same list of the holy names. But now, you have Prem. And if you don't have Prem, Bhagavan will not give you darshan. Will not take you to Goloka Vrindavan. Two things are necessary to see Bhagavan. Prema should come in your heart. If you don't have a prema in your heart, then Bhagavan will not give darshan. If you have prema, Ashtasatvik Vikar will come, 8 symptoms of ecstasy, and also you'll be dancing, singing, sometimes rolling on the ground. Sometimes you say that this body cannot tolerate the prema, she is asking. Then God gives you a transcendental body, This transcendental body, then you can tolerate the love. So people say that tiger. The milk of the tigers, female tiger, can only be kept in a golden pot. If you put the milk of a tigress, female tiger, in a clay pot, it will burst. I never experienced this. Have you? Have you tried this experience? Milk of the tigress can only be kept in a golden pot. not in a clay pot, otherwise the clay pot will burst. Have you tried this?
Do you remember in Jaiva Dharma, Babaji Maharaj, you speak with in the beginning? What is the name of the speaker? Very beginning.
Sannyasa Thakur? Sannyasa Thakur, Vaishnava Das?
Vaishnava Das and Babaji Maharaj, they discuss.
This?
No, I'm just remember one question.
Okay. So that, yes. Mujhe prana se pyare ho. So in that Hindi kirtan, one devotee was asking to Gurudeva, Gurudeva, you are more dear to me than my own life. Okay. What is the meaning of this? Like, I like more you than myself, my own life. But this is possible for someone? Nothing can be more dear to you than your own life here. Do you understand? This is for someone. This one story of Chakravarti Shivaji. Chakravarti Shivaji.
Chhatrapati.
Chhatrapati Shivaji. Sorry, another meaning.
Chhatrapati.
Chhatrapati Shivaji.
Maharashtra ke jo hai. Chhatrapati Shivaji ke.
One person from Maharashtra. Chhatravarti Shivaji. He was a boy from a rich family. His guru would love him so much also. So wherever his guru used to go, he used to always put his hand on the shoulder of Chhatravarti Shivaji, his disciple. But the other disciples were thinking, Gurudeva doesn't love us so much as he loves him. Because whatever Gurudeva does, walking, sleeping, eating, he's always holding the shoulder of Chhatravarti Shivaji. So they complained, the other disciples complained. Like they started to speak about this, you know, these other disciples. Ah, Shivaji, Gurudeva, why Gurudeva loves him so much, this disciple? Because because he's from a rich family. He was from a rich family. Ah, that must be because of this. That's why maybe Gurudeva gives him so much like love and affection. People of this world, they think these things, yeah. So somehow this like rumor came to Guru's ears, like Gurudeva got to know what they were thinking about. Then one day Gurudeva called all the disciples and told, okay, Gurudeva, you are dear to us than our own life here. Can anyone be dear to you than your own life? This is only like a lip service. It's not real. Maybe for some time, just to get some wealth, or just to show off, maybe you're doing something like that. You can even cut your head and give to Guru, but some emotional sometimes, some emotion coming. Some people say, I can do that, I can, yes. But not forever, not like not in all circumstances. Does it? Maybe for 1 or 2 days? But in the third day, he'll run away automatically. But the story of Shivaji, all the disciples were saying, oh, because he's from rich family, that's why Gurudev gives him affection, because he's giving like so much money or something like that. That Gurudev called all the disciples one day and told, I'm dear to you than your own life? Dear? More dear? Yes, yes, Gurudev. Then the Guru told, look, okay, you see that female tiger, take out, like milk her tits, no, this other, and take the milk from her. But if you go to the tigress, she'll eat you alive. So how can, but this is shown to Gurudev, Gurudev is dear from you, more dear than your own life. Then this devotee, Shivaji, he went immediately to the female tiger, took the milk in a golden pot, came back and gave to Gurudev. Got it? This is not my kata. Gurudev used to tell this story, okay? I didn't make this test, but you can test and see. Test if really, if you put the milk of the tigers in the clay pot, it will burst. The pot will burst. So this is being Gurudev is dear to you in your life. Actually, you like the most in your body, you like the most
more dear than
the dearest thing you have is your plan, life here. But think something was dear to you. When you have completely surrender, then you can have something which is dearer than your own life here. Yeah. Of course, Gurudev gave him potency that he could do. If Gurudev gives potency in someone, then the person can do that. What is, of course. But Gurudev gives the Shakti, the potency, to that person who has the recipients, the proper recipient to get that Shakti. Gurudev, give the Shakti to me. No. I also do this. Like, for example, Rupa Goswami. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself put all the Shakti in the heart of Rupa. Then Rupa Goswami, he could write all these books. Like Jalani Lamani and Dagda Madhav, Narita Mardav, and also the Giraj Govardhanashtakam. Rupa Goswami wrote all this. How did he write all these things? Actually, he knew the Baba Mahaprabhu, then that's why, how he wrote all this. Do you get it?
Yeah.
If you say, why he didn't give this mercy to others, only to Rupa Goswami? Everyone was a disciple of Mahaprabhu, right? Even great personalities. Do you understand? So why specifically to Rupa Goswami, Pad? You tell me. So tanta secha my purush.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Shankar hai.
Mahaprabhu himself said. When I met Rupa Goswami in Prayag, I gave all my Shakti to him. I manifest all my potency in his heart. Mahaprabhu said, Rupa is qualified. That's why I gave all potency. And by his potency, he's writing all these books, everything you see. That's why how he manifested all this.
Que o Mahaprabhu deu a misericórdia para o Rupa Goswami porque ele era qualificado e aí ele em Prayag encontrou com ele e deu toda a Shakti no coração dele, Shakti Sancharita dele. Por que foi o Rupa Goswami especificamente?
So he gave the potency to that because Rupa was qualified? Gurudev saying, Yoga Patra Janetari Shakti Sancharila. I saw he was qualified, that's why I gave the Shakti in his heart. So if you're qualified, if you're surrendered, you're qualified. Well, but Sanatana Goswami also Maharaj, she's asking. Yes, everybody was qualified. But Mahaprabhu said, I knew he was qualified. God is Svatanta Chalmai Purush, like his independence. God is independence. You can say Swarup Damodara was not qualified as well. Right? Or Radhamananda also, he wasn't qualified. Then Mahaprabhu said, when I met him in Prayag, I saw he was qualified and I gave the Shakti. Bhagavan Svatanta Sachamai Purush.
Manda naquele grupo, Prabhu. Você pega, bota lá papo pra gente, ajuda.
So suppose you have 10 crore rupees, you have 100 million rupees. So you give this money to whom? You will give it to which kid, which one of your sons? Like you're supposed to have a lot of money and have many sons. You will give the money to that son that can use properly your money that you have earned your whole life. If you give this money to your son, which is like a drunkard or like a only like a junkie or something, then the son will just waste all your money. She's saying, but what about the equal love to all the sons? Yeah, this is another story. But no. I think she was telling the story about the Kali Yuga, you know, that the is giving to the most, the worst son. Gurudev Singh, this is another story, another story. So, Mahaprabhu saw the Rupa was qualified, but others were not qualified as well? Like Rai Ramananda was also super qualified. Rai Ramananda also, okay, others were like young, but okay, Rai Ramananda was not an ordinary person. So why didn't give to him also? Because Rupa Goswami was Manjari, but Sanatana Goswami was also Manjari. Lokanandas Goswami was also Manjari. It's not a matter of being a Manjari.
Mahaprabhu? ये युक्ति दिखा ठीक है मेन युक्ति क्या है जैसे आप बोल रहे हैं ये भी जैवधर्म ग्रंथ में
लिखा है व्हाट यू आर सेइंग इज आल्सो रिटन इन द जैवधर्म यू कैन रीड
किंतु वास्तव होता है क्या स्वतंत्र स्वेच्छामय पुरुष भगवान
एक्चुअली द ट्रुथ इज दैट गॉड इज स्वतंत्र हमारे पहचान इज इंडिपेंडेंस स्वतंत्र स्वेच्छामय पुरुष भगवान ही कैन गिव लाइक इट्स माय मनी कैन गिव टू एनीवन राइट Why did I give to that person? Because I'm independent. God is independent. He can give what he wants to anyone. And this is not your matter. It's not your business. You cannot make a question about it. Like what you're saying is 100%. Yes. It's perfect. What he said? Kya bataya?
Kintu jadi hum vichar kare.
Number one.
Abhi na humare bhai Rupa Goswami baat thi to aur bhi shrestha the.
But still, of course, Rupa Goswami was.
क्या बताया
महाप्रभु के समय सब एक एक से कम नहीं एक एक से बड़े तो गुस्से बात क्यों दिया
So why Rupa Goswami he gave? Mahaprabhu said, I knew he was qualified, so I gave him all the potency. So the, he told his Yogapatra, he's qualified, that's why I gave, Mahaprabhu told. But the others were not qualified, so if you say qualified Yoga. So it's written that actually Mahaprabhu is Svatantra Satchamaya Purush, he's independent God. The independent God. Because of this, he can give to anyone he likes. God has also one quality. He makes the non-qualified become qualified also. That person who cannot speak starts speaking very well. Those who cannot walk start walking so quickly. But but he didn't have heard all these bhavas. Then he was Rupa Manjari. Gurudev said, yes, of course. But this is Leela of how to manifest these things. Anyway, the duty of Guru, Shrimad Bhagavatam, first canto of the Bhagavatam, it's explained. Snake the Sisha. Guru will give all the potency in the heart of the disciple who is qualified. So, why Guru gives one and not the other, for example? You might say. If to give to one disciple, why not the other? Like I told, you have 10 million rupees and you have 4 kids, 4 sons. To which son will you give? One son is stupid nonsense, another son likes to drink a lot and get wasted every day. Another is Biragi. What is Biragi? Biragi? Renounced? Detached. Detached. Is that renounced? But another one is one of the sons is under your guidance and everything. So you have 4 sons, you will give to whom? You just take prasadam.
Yes.
So you will give to which son? That son that accepts your orders and follow your instructions. So if so much effort all your life, you earn that money and then you not give this to the stupid nonsense boy, your son who is going here and there, many ladies, and also if you give to the son who is vairagi, he's also not involved. No benefit also to giving to this detached son. But if you give to the son who is like really under your guidance, and if you give all your efforts, the fruit of your efforts, your money, if you give to this son who is under your guidance and everything, then you'll be proper. So of course all are qualified, but this is Lila, just to teach the jivas in this world. Do you understand? Surapa Damodar was nothing less.
Rayaramanda
was also not. Bhattacharya, all of them, they are really scholars. If you say Manjari, but Sanatana Goswami was not a Manjari also. Or Raghunatha Das Goswami, wasn't he a Manjari as well?
उचित ये शब्द आप कह सकते हैं अंत में आपके कंक्लूजन क्या निकलेगा स्वतंत्र से क्षमा
पुरुष एंड द कंक्लूजन इज दैट ही इज इंडिपेंडेंट स्वतंत्र भगवान इज स्वतंत्र से क्षमा पुरुष ही कैन गिव टू एनीवन ही लाइक्स
सो उदाहरण दिया आप
सो गिव एन एग्जांपल एग्जांपल ऑफ द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड
किंतु गुरु क्या करते मूर्ख को भी दे देते क्यों मूर्ख के भी पंडित बना सकते
सो द गुरु कैन मेक अ फुलिश पर्सन बिकम अ पंडित आल्सो
वाचलम
Mukham karoti vachalam. He can make even the dumb become a great speaker, eloquent, and those who cannot walk can cross mountains. So this is the glory of the guru, to make someone who is not qualified become qualified. Sometimes I tell the story of the a king had four sons. The king has so much money, he had full of money.
तो राजा
विचार
कर
चार बेटे कहने लगे
साल के बाद
सो ही गिव ओके आफ्टर वन ईयर आई वांट टू सी हाउ मच यू प्रॉफिटेड फ्रॉम दिस मनी सो ही कॉल्ड द फोर सन्स So he gave 100,000 rupees for the first son. So the first son when came back, he made four times the money back. Like he came back with 400,000.
Okay, like 3,000.
So he said, oh my father, so the other son,
So
the father was very happy.
His
son had given back his 100,000 back and also made 300,000 more. Second son also came back and told, oh my father, I could not do as my older brother, but at least 300,000 rupees I would make able to profit. So you take your capital back, 100,000 that you gave me, and I also made more, 200,000. Father said, oh, very nice. Oh, the third son, what did you do? Father, I also couldn't do so much. I only doubled the money. So 100,000, you take your money back, your capital, and then 100,000 also I made more. Father said, okay, very nice also. So the first son was like excellent. Father told excellent. No, when you get the marks in the school, you get excellence, like excellence. Like 100% you got in the marks of an exam. Like somebody has the golden, another silver, copper, iron, you know, the marks, like some position of the marks in the school. I remember in my school.
And monthly examination.
Every month there was an examination. In different subjects. So there were like four positions for the best positions in this course. Diamond, golden, silver, copper or bronze, I don't remember. So that one who was diamond was excellent. To make these small kids more have enthusiasm for study.
Right?
So remember, the third son doubled the money, but the fourth son He was sitting very far from the father. He didn't have properly clothes. He was not even wearing proper clothes. Not proper clothes. Worn out clothes. Just like a beggar. He was completely like a beggar, really. Nothing to eat. He was sitting so far. He was crying also. I couldn't do as like my brothers. Oh my. But the father called him. Hey, come here. Son, come here. He didn't want to come. He was so ashamed. Oh, my father gave me 100,000. All my brothers, they made so nice. No, they doubled the money, tripled the money, fourth the money. And so he got hold of the feet of his father and he cried, oh, father, I'm so unqualified, oh my father. Father told, son, I gave you 100,000 rupees. What did you do with the money? Then he caught the feet of his father and was crying and crying. Oh, my father, that money you gave to me, I'm so unqualified. You know, you give me the money, but I wasted everything. Then the father told with so much love, my son, tell me, what did you give? I gave 100,000 rupees. Then the young son told, actually, I spent half of it, 50,000, in the brothel. Then I also saw one place of gambling. Also, I also bet the other part and I lost also everything. So I don't have anything. Half in the prostitute place, half in the like casino. So now I don't even have clothes, nothing. I'm a beggar, my father. I'm like dying like from hunger. You called to me, then I came because I lost everything actually. But hearing his son, the father, his like his eyes with tears, the father was emotion, like in tears in his eyes. Then father called the maid, like a servant, and called the servant and told, oh, you know, my chest, open my safe, you know, the safe chest, and take all the money I have there and give to my younger son. The other brothers, father, how possible? He's a foolish. If you'll give it to him, he'll waste everything. But we see how we did so much, so well, and you're not giving to us. Jai Maharaj, dhanyavad. Please come, Maharaj. The father told, look, don't make noise, this is my money. Don't make noise, it's my money. I can give to anyone, okay? This is my business. Be peaceful. Then the father told, I gave 100,000 and you made 400,000 of this, so you can do your own very well. You the other one also that made it three times the money, two times the money. You can solve yourself by, like, you can live by yourself, like, you can manage yourself. But this one, after I depart, he will be even more poor and poorer and poorer, and he cannot handle himself. So I am giving my money to him, but I'm also giving all my potency to him now. He will not waste the money. He won't waste the money this time. He will not waste my money this time. So what is this four sons? Satya, Treta, Dvapara, Kali, four yugas. So in Satya Yuga, people used to meditate. And they were meditating, and so much benefit they were getting, so much power and these things. In Treta Yuga, they were also performing five sacrifices, and they were also getting so much from this. In the prayoga from puja, they're also like getting money, or meaning of getting money is actually like they were attaining God, they were benefiting from these things. But in Kali Yuga, what is Kali Yuga? There's nothing in Kali Yuga, nothing. Only faults in Kali Yuga, only faults. Everything is so false, like full of flaws. So
एक कलियुग है, छोटे बच्चा जो मान बच्चा
जो बड़ा कलियुग है, the youngest son is representing Kali Yuga. So that king told, so I give my wealth to him. Which wealth? Harinam, the best wealth. So when he opened his chest, his safe, what did he give to the youngest son? Harinam. This Harinam, with this Harinam, his heart will be purified. In other yugas, that wealth that you could get in other yugas, in Kali Yuga, only by Nama Sankirtan, you will get thousand, like so much more with the Harinam. So two teachings. One, God is independent. He can give to anyone. Like Mahaprabhu also, he gave this very rare love, this wealth, rare even for demigods. This Anapitacharin Shatsloka explains. So, why he gave this highest wealth to the humans of the Kali Yuga? In Western countries, some Western devotee was asking Gurudeva. Then Gurudeva said, he's independent, he can give to anyone. What do you have to do with this? Another point. A normal person, for example, if there's a flood somewhere, if a normal minister comes, he'll be able to help in some proportion those people who are needy. But a president, if a president comes to that area, he'll help so much to all those residents in the area because he has so much also like prerogative. Like for example, a poor person comes, he can give 2 rupees in donation. People even... Sorry. If a poor person gives 2 rupees, everybody's like, okay, thank you so much for helping. But if a rich person gives 2 rupees, you'll say, what is this? Nothing. You're so like miser. So if some poor person gives 2 rupees, he'll get the status that he helped like this. But if a rich person gives 2 rupees, then everybody like, oh, it's nothing. Insult him. So Mahaprabhu, he's God, Supreme God, independent. He's the combined form of Radha and Krishna. Mahaprabhu. Gurudev told this kata. So first of all, he's independent. He can give to anyone. You don't have anything to do with that. In Kali Yuga, the human beings.
तो उसी प्रकार ये भी शब्द प्रयोग करे मुकुं करोति वाचालं पंगु लंगति गुरी क्या नहीं कर सकते.
But by the mercy of God, what can't you do? Like what can you not do, right? Guru Pramana.
Krishna please.
The story of the mango and the beans. Can you tell here, please? You speak here. That story. No, but in English. I don't understand. Please, you tell me.
No. Para. Gurudev is saying that till the time we do not have anubhav, right? Mm. How can we tell that this is, what is that? Like, suppose there is a story that Gurudev is telling that there is a person and he went to a place and there was chosam.
Chosam means?
It's a type of... It's a variety of mango.
Mm-hmm.
So, if he eats that mango and comes to his, when he came to his house, one of the family members said, how is the taste of that mango?
Mm.
So the person said that, how can I tell you how is the taste? So he did one thing, like little bit mango was left on his beard.
Mm.
So he just, you know, rubbed all the mango. He rubbed all the mango on his beard and said that, now lick it and see how's the mango. So here it is true.
And because the other person was asking this taste of the mango, he could not explain in words. So there was some mango in his beard. Then he told...
He rubbed it.
Rubbed and took some rasa out of it, some liquid, and told him to
lick it.
Lick it and feel the taste. What is the name of the mango? Chosa.
Chosam.
Is there one special kind of mango?
There are many types of mangoes, variety of mangoes, like 52, 62, there are many types of mangoes.
Okay.
So it is one of the variety, chosam.
Chosam, okay. That's it, no? Okay. So like you cannot explain the taste only by tasting yourself.
Yes. It's the expression. We can't express that thing. It's only because when we do anubhav, then only we...
When we have realization, okay. Thank you. Hare Krishna Didi.